Welcome to projectbazaar.com. Now let me discuss about the title of the project. Our title of the project is Privacy Preserving Clinical Decision Support System Using Gaussian Kernel Based Classification. In this paper, we are going to propose about a clinical decision support system, that is a computerized medical diagnosis process for enhancing health-related decisions and actions with pertinent organized healthcare knowledge and patient data to improve the health and healthcare delivery. In this paper, we are going to propose a privacy-preserving clinical decision support system which preserves the privacy of the patient data, the decision, and the service clinical decision support system parameters. This is the main objective of our process. Now, let me discuss about the object of our project. In this paper, we are going to propose the privacy preserving clinical decision support system. It preserves the privacy of the person, so the patient data, the decision, and the same service clinical decision support system parameters. In this, we consider a decision support system developed using the SVM support vector machine, which is one of the machine learning tools which has been widely used to predict the various diseases in biomedical engineering. A clinical decision support forms the critical capability to link the health observations with the health knowledge to inform choices by clinicians for improved health care. In this scenario, clinicians can use the health knowledge located in remote servers via the internet to diagnose the patient. However, the fact that the servers are third party and therefore potentially not fully authorized possible privacy concerns. Then in this paper, we propose a novel privacy preserving protocol for a clinical decision support system where the patient's data always remain in encrypted form during the diagnosis process. Hence, the server involved in the diagnosis process is not able to learn any extra knowledge about the patient data and results. Our experiment results on popular medical data sets from HD machine used to database demonstrate the accuracy of the proposed protocol to 97.21% and the privacy of person data is not compromised. Let me discuss about the data flow diagram of our process. In this process, first project is the input data set function. In that input data set, we are collecting the details about a patient or something disease-oriented data set from using machine learning repository. Our input data set is schema adaptive data set. In that, various attributes are present like age, pedigree level, skin level, serum level, thickness level, etc. This is our input data set. After the data set has been loaded, we have to load the data set into a database. After the data set loaded into a database, we are going to partition in the data set. That is, partitioning means we are going to classify the data set based on the class values in the data set. After the data set has been partitioned, we are going to normalize the data by using some techniques in our big paper. In that normalization, we are going to compute the mean and standard deviations for every process. After the normalization is completed, we are going to implement the process by using the normalized data. After the data normalization, we are going to encrypt the data by using the new cryptographic technique called Parallel Cryptographic Technique. This is encrypted by using some big integer values. This is more advantages when compared with the other algorithms like RSA LGML encryption. It is similar to a LGML encryption, but these enters too long when compared with LGML encryption. After encrypting the data, we are going to decrypt the data. The encrypted data has been stored in a server. After the server receives the encrypted data, server decrypts by using the private key. After the server decrypts the data, then server performs some decision operations in server, that is called SVM classification process is used in a server. After SVM classification is completed, we are going to improve the classification accuracy by using that decision support system. This is the data flow diagram of our process. Now, let me discuss about the demo of our process. First, the perturbed that have been viewed in the processes for the record particular, meaning that we are going to partition the data like malignant and benign. Just like the benign show, then just like the benign in the data and in the data. And this is the record particular. The record particular is considered, then clicking at the button for viewing the attributes of the data. This is the attribute of the data. After the attribute of the data, then let's clicking at the button. Then let's try the data to the validation. In this, we are calculating the mean and standard deviation process. After the process has been completed, we are going to normalize the table. The table has been successfully normalized. In this, we are going to choose the training data. Extract the data is successfully calculated. After the normalization has been completed, we are going to include the data by using cryptographic technique called failure encryption. In that, we are going to generate the cryptographic for data. This is a filtering process by using the failure encryption. After the encryption process has been completed, we are going to get the public key and private key values. This is the key values for encrypted data. Then the key has to send to a server, passing the encrypted file to server. Then the private key server and that file. The server receiving the encrypted file. Encrypted has been stored successfully in the server. This is the decryption key. Then person operation is used on the inner server. Then get and key for encryption decryption and decrypt the data. Data has been used by using. Then decrypted file is right. Then after transferring the data, if the testing and training data, data is successfully entered into database. After this, we are going to train the data applications. And after we are going to extract the data, training and the data successfully. After we have to test accuracy levels of mean and correlation coefficient of data. In that, we are going to get the accuracy level like 70.29%. After the classification is done properly, we are going to train the data. This is our training data. Then after the training data, we are from the training specific data successfully. Then get accuracy results. Our accuracy results are mean 0.09 and decision value is 0.0 something. And validation accuracy is 90.4974%. Then we are going to evaluate the existing system and the supporting system based on the accuracy levels. Our existing system accuracy level is 80%. Our proposed system accuracy level is 90%. This is a complete demo of our project. Thank you for watching.